and the House of Representatives, representatives of the leadership of the National Assembly, permit me to very warmly thank you for giving us audience at very short notice to pay this courtesy visit on you, and with the big request that, knowing fully well that the National Assembly is the representative of the almost 200 million Nigerians, that we bring our plea to you. It is not lost on us that today you have a valedictory sitting of the 8th Assembly, and it's against this backdrop that we have decided to pay the National Assembly a visit. We strongly believe that you still have the capacity to act and to make pronouncements as the custodians of the Nigerian Constitution and the protector-in-chief of the constitutional rights and freedoms of the Nigerian people. It is with this background and this belief that we have decided to write this letter to you. First, I must say that Section 39 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria provides the right to freedom of expression and freedom of the press. Your Excellencies are aware that these rights are formed part of the foundation for the struggle for return to civil rule. The exercise of these rights and the respect of these freedoms also gave strong impetus for the APC's campaign that culminated in victory in 2015 general elections and the first ever defeat of a ruling party in Nigeria and possibly in the whole of Africa. However, in recent times, we have witnessed a very strong attempt by officials within this government to clamp down on media and stifle the right to freedom of expression as contained in the Constitution. Some of the instances include the illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Jones Abiri, a journalist in Bayelsa State, for over 2 years without charge. The illegal clampdown and closure of the offices of Daily Trust newspapers in 3 cities of the country, namely Abuja, Lagos, and Maiduguri. The illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Samuel Ogundipe of Premium Times for failing to reveal the source from whom he got information for his story he published. The illegal arrest and detention of the Lumber Brothers, publishers of elomba.com, an online news platform. The illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Anthony Ezimako, the Abuja Bureau Chief of Daily Independent Newspapers, who was arrested because he did a story on the activities of the Boko Haram terrorist organization. The illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Abubakar Usman, aka Abu Sadiq, a publisher of AbuSadiq.com, an online news platform, and the repeated harassment of Mr. Ahmed Salkida, an investigative journalist who publishes articles on the activities of Boko Haram terrorist organization, amongst others. We have observed the sustained and repeated attempts by the National Broadcasting Commission of Nigeria, NBC, to influence our editorial standpoint by means of harassment, intimidation, and threats of fines and revocation of our broadcast license. Most recently, their efforts are focused on censoring a program aired by African Independent Television, AIT. The program in question, Kakaki Social, which holds in the mornings on weekdays, curates the thoughts and opinions of ordinary Nigerians as expressed on social media regarding a variety of topics. It is important to note that this program generates none of the content published but only curates and publishes the thoughts and opinions of the Nigerian public on critical issues. On the 27th of November, the NBC wrote a letter querying the producers of the program for publishing opinions of Nigerians over the threat by militants in the Niger Delta to declare a Niger Delta Republic on June 1st, 2019. The threat by the militants was widely reported in every media, print, TV, radio, and online media houses in the country. However, for some unknown reason, the program was singled out by the NBC and accused of issuing a call to war and being outrightly inciting. This accusation was made in spite of the fact that most of the comments published on the program condemned the threats of secession and called for national unity. Distinguished leaders of the National Assembly, I believe that there's hardly anybody in Nigeria that does not know that I'm a very strong federalist, that I believe in the unity and the stability of this country, and that I'm committed, and that communications is also committed, to the unity and continuity of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. But as a result of this presentation, the station is now being threatened with sanctions, including a possible shutdown by the NBC. These threats constitute an attempt to abridge the rights of Nigerians to freedom of expression and the rights to freedom of the press and of the media. While we acknowledge NBC's right to provide regulations for media houses in the country, we believe, and our belief is backed by decided case law, that the Commission does not have the authority to provide editorial direction and content for media houses. In a constitutional democracy such as ours, any attempt to provide authoritarian editorial direction must be viewed as censorship and an attempt to abrogate the rights and freedoms of the Nigerian people. A combination of these incidents recounted in the past and the ongoing incident give the impression in the minds of many Nigerians that one Mr. Kawu Modibo, who is Director General of the NBC, is harsh, draconian, and unwilling to allow broadcasters exercise their constitutional duties. It is for this reason that we submit this petition to you to intervene in this matter and call on NBC to show respect for the rights of the Nigerian people, to call for the Director General of the NBC to recuse himself from the regulatory affairs of the NBC for reasons provided in this petition, and for the National Assembly to review and amend the National Broadcasting Act 1992, which is now outdated, and indeed is in dire need to take cognizance of Nigeria's status as a constitutional democracy, to recognize the National Assembly as the befitting institution to vet and clear its leadership and members of the board, to put emphasis on professional qualifications to the appointment of board members, and restrain active politicians from leading the commission. Such an intervention will not only put an end to the cases at hand, but will also prevent a repeated occurrence of such incidents in the future. Your Excellency, since coming to office in 2015, and in compliance with a well-scripted program of action to shut down the DAAR Communications brand from Nigeria's broadcasting landscape, we have been inundated with letters from our regulator, the National Broadcasting Commission. Every broadcast which appears to offer a dissenting perspective to the position of government is reprehended as threat to national interest. Every reference and reportage from various sections of the country concerning injustice, inequality, and iniquity is reprehended as a threat to national security. We hold the position that it is the actions or lack of actions by government in responding to the above that threaten public order, public interest, public cohesion, the peace and unity of this country, and not the reportage of sin. It is our view that communications, including broadcasting, as a form of mass communication, serves public interest when the media is able to inform and educate the public on the activities and initiatives of government, whilst also availing people in government an opportunity to feel the pulse of the nation by reporting unadulterated comments, opinions, and perspectives without censorship. By so doing, leaders, including the president, can assess and discern the value of diverse opinions and positions. I make bold to state, SAS, as founder and chairman emeritus of DAAR Communications PLC, that our objective from inception to this day remained one: to inform, educate, and entertain, to serve the interests of the Nigerian public, to set agenda for social, cultural, economic, political, and technological development of our nation, and to hold the government and the people in power accountable to the people in pursuance of public interest over government or personal interest. These goals and objectives are derived from the character and objectives of broadcasting as defined in the NBC code. However, it is important to note that there are areas of conflict between certain provisions of the NBC code, the responsibility of our professional obligations, the law and the constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. It is our view that where such conflicts exist, we must prioritize public interest in aiding, in abiding by the constitution and laws of the Federal Republic over and above the provisions of the NBC code. SAS, I need to state very clearly that in the commission, questioning our right as a media house to even have opinion, we run editorial, we run a commentary. Every media house in any part of the world has a right to actually on its own come out what it desires or what it thinks is the right of that media house on a given issue of national interest. And when the issue of the president of the Court of Appeal presiding over the election petition, based on international law, based on the information available from us, from the NJC rules and regulations, based on the practices, decided cases in court, we came forward and actually stated that it is the opinion of the editorial board and therefore the opinion of DAAR Communications that the president of the Court of Appeal should recuse itself from presiding over the issue. It is a right enshrined in the constitution, the right of freedom of expression, the right to really stipulate and take a position on a given national issue. But what did we get? A letter from the National Broadcasting Commission accusing us that we were one-sided, that we didn't give the APC, that it was contempt of court. Is it the NBC that will determine contempt of court, or is a court of law duly constituted and duly authorized by our constitution to determine whether there's contempt or law? There are provisions, there are ways, there are processes. But now they say they are prepared to shut us down. I want to state that that every step we have taken in defense of articulating the events, the injustices that have been happening, the lack, the erosion of unity in the country by the acts and decisions of the state and the House of Representatives, representatives of the leadership of the National Assembly, permit me to very warmly thank you for giving us audience at very short notice to pay this courtesy visit on you, and with the big request that, knowing fully well that the National Assembly is the representative of the almost 200 million Nigerians that will bring our plea to you. It is not lost on us that today you have a valedictory sitting of the 8th Assembly, and it's against this backdrop that we have decided to pay the National Assembly a visit. We strongly believe that you still have the capacity to act and to make pronouncements as the custodians of the Nigerian Constitution and the protector-in-chief of the constitutional rights and freedoms of the Nigerian people. It is with this background and this belief that we have decided to write this letter to you. First, I must say that Section 39 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria provides the right to freedom of expression and freedom of the press. Your Excellencies are aware that these rights are formed part of the foundation for the struggle for return to civil rule. The exercise of these rights and the respect of these freedoms also gave strong impetus for the APC's campaign that culminated in victory in 2015 general elections and the first ever defeat of a ruling party in Nigeria and possibly in the whole of Africa. However, in recent times, we have witnessed a very strong attempt by officials within this government to clamp down on media and stifle the right to freedom of expression as contained in the Constitution. Some of the instances include the illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Jones Abiri, a journalist in Bayelsa State, for over 2 years without charge. The illegal clampdown and closure of the offices of Daily Trust newspapers in 3 cities of the country, namely Abuja, Lagos, and Maiduguri. The illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Samuel Ogundipe of Premium Times for failing to reveal the source from whom he got information for his story he published. The illegal arrest and detention of the Elomba brothers, publishers of Elomba.com, an online news platform. The illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Anthony Ezimako, the Abuja bureau chief of Daily Independent Newspapers, who was arrested because he did a story on the activities of the Boko Haram terrorist organization. The illegal arrest and detention of Mr. Abubakar Usman, aka Abu Sadiq, a publisher of AbuSadiq.com, an online news platform. And the repeated harassment of Mr. Ahmed Salkida, an investigative journalist who publishes articles on the activities of Boko Haram terrorist organization, amongst others. We have observed the sustained and repeated attempts by the National Broadcasting Commission of Nigeria, NBC, to influence our editorial standpoint by means of harassment, intimidation, and threats of fines and revocation of our broadcast license. Most recently, their efforts are focused on censoring a program aired by African Independent Television, AIT. The program in question, Kakaki Social, which hosts in the mornings on weekdays, curates the thoughts and opinions of ordinary Nigerians as expressed on social media regarding a variety of topics. It is important to note that this program generates none of the content published, but only curates and publishes the thoughts and opinions of the Nigerian public on critical issues. On the 27th of November, the NBC wrote a letter querying the producers of the program for publishing opinions of Nigerians over the threat by militants in the Niger Delta to declare a Niger Delta Republic on June 1st, 2019. The threat by the militants was widely reported in every media, print, TV, radio, and online media houses in the country. However, for some unknown reason, the program was singled out by the NBC and accused of issuing a call to war and being outrightly inciting. This accusation was made in spite of the fact that most of the comments published on the program condemned the threats of secession and called for national unity. Distinguished leaders of the National Assembly, I believe that there's hardly anybody in Nigeria that does not know that I'm a very strong federalist, that I believe in the unity and the stability of this country, and that I'm committed, and their communications is also committed, to the unity and continuity of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. But as a result of this presentation, the station is now being threatened with sanctions, including a possible shutdown by the NBC. These threats constitute an attempt to abridge the rights of Nigerians to freedom of expression and the rights to freedom of the press and of the media. While we acknowledge NBC's right to provide regulations for media houses in the country, we believe, and our belief is backed by decided case law, that the Commission does not have the authority to provide editorial direction and content for media houses. In a constitutional democracy such as ours, any attempt to provide authoritarian editorial direction must be viewed as censorship and an attempt to abrogate the rights and freedoms of the Nigerian people. A combination of these incidents recounted in the past and the ongoing incident give the impression in the minds of many Nigerians that one Mr. Kawu Modibo, who is Director General of the NBC, is harsh, draconian, and unwilling to allow broadcasters exercise their constitutional duties. It is for this reason that we submit this petition to you to intervene in this matter and call on NBC to show respect for the rights of the Nigerian people, to call for the Director General of the NBC to recuse himself from the regulatory affairs of the NBC for reasons provided in this petition, and for the National Assembly to review and amend the National Broadcasting Act 1992, which is now outdated and indeed is in dire need to take cognizance of Nigeria's status as a constitutional democracy, to recognize the National Assembly as the befitting institution to vet and clear its leadership and members of the board, to put emphasis on professional qualifications to the appointment of board members, and restrain active politicians from leading the commission. Such an intervention will not only put an end to the cases at hand, but will also prevent a repeated occurrence of such incidents in the future. Your Excellency, since coming to office in 2015, and in compliance with a well-scripted program of action to shut down the DAAR Communications brand from Nigeria's broadcasting landscape, we have been inundated with letters from our regulator, the National Broadcasting Commission. Every broadcast which appears to offer a dissenting perspective to the position of government is reprehended as a threat to national interest. Every reference and reportage from various sections of the country concerning injustice, inequality, and iniquity is reprehended as a threat to national security. We hold the position that it is the actions or lack of actions by government in responding to the above that threaten public order, public interest, public cohesion, the peace and unity of this country, and not the reportage of sin. It is our view that communications, including broadcasting, as a form of mass communication, serves public interest when the media is able to inform and educate the public on the activities and initiatives of government, whilst also availing people in government an opportunity to feel the pulse of the nation by reporting unadulterated comments, opinions, and perspectives without censorship. By so doing, leaders, including the president, can assess and discern the value of diverse opinions and positions. I make bold to state, sirs, as founder and chairman emeritus of DAAR Communications PLC, that our objective from inception to this day remained one: to inform, educate, and entertain, to serve the interests of the Nigerian public, to set agenda for social, cultural, economic, political, and technological development of our nation, and to hold the government and the people in power accountable to the people in pursuance of public interest over government or personal interest. These goals and objectives are derived from the character and objectives of broadcasting as defined in the NBC code. However, it is important to note that there are areas of conflict between certain provisions of the NBC code, the responsibility of our professional obligations, the law and the constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. It is our view that where such conflicts exist, we must prioritize public interest in aiding, in abiding by the constitution and laws of the Federal Republic over and above the provisions of the NBC code. Sirs, I need to state very clearly that in the commission questioning our right as a media house to even have opinion, we ran editorial, we ran a commentary. Every media house in any part of the world has a right to actually on its own come out what it desires or what it thinks is the right of that media house on a given issue of national interest. And when the issue of the president of the Court of Appeal presiding over the election petition, based on international law, based on the information available from us, from the NJC rules and regulations, based on the practices, decided cases in court, we came forward and actually stated that it is the opinion of the editorial board and therefore the opinion of DAAR Communications that the president of the Court of Appeal should recuse itself from presiding over the issue. It is a right enshrined in the Constitution, the right of freedom of expression, the right to really stipulate and take a position on a given national issue. But what did we get? A letter from the National Broadcasting Commission accusing us that we were one-sided, that we didn't give the APC, that it was contempt of court. Is it the NBC that will determine contempt of court, or is a court of law duly constituted and duly authorized by our constitution to determine whether there's contempt or law? There are provisions, there are ways, there are processes. But now they say they are prepared to shut us down. I want to state that that every step we have taken in defense of articulating the events, the injustices that have been happening, the lack, the erosion of unity in the country by the acts and decisions of the present APC-led federal government has been met with a lot of reprehension by the officials of the National Broadcasting Commission. They say AIT, Ray Power, or DAAR Communications as a whole is partisan. But the truth of the matter is that I believe you will recall that during the third term saga in this country, that AIT stood on the part of the National Assembly and the people of Nigeria, even when there was a PDP government, to say no. The interest of the people of Nigeria must be protected and projected. And we stood and we came out very clearly with editorials at that time to say, President Olusegun Obasanjo, there is no provision for tenure extension. You have served your time, bow out honorably. During President Umaru Yar'Adua, the doctrine of necessity, again, we stood out and we defended. In 2015, 2011 to 2015, we came out when there was the first subsidy issue in support of the Nigerian people. We have always stood on the side of the Nigerian people. That is our primary obligation. But here we are, we are being accused of partisanship. But generally, I must quickly add that the partisanship that we are being accused of is by the leadership of the NBC itself. That the man that currently heads the National Broadcasting Commission contested election in Kwara State and failed and returned to the returned to office, and that it is he that is a representative of the APC and is using his office to guard and close down most of the stations. We therefore, I believe that we need to appeal to the National Assembly to please kindly consider the urgent need to review the National Broadcasting Commission to ensure that partisan persons like Mr. Kawu and Modibo is shown the way out of the NBC so that the Nigerian media can have a breath, a fresh air. Thank you very much. I'm sorry.
Distinguished members of the press, we have with us here the common sense senator, the person that is distinguished senator, Ben Murray Bruce. Thank you. We are here on behalf of the two arms of the National Assembly to receive your letters and also to receive your protest. We have carefully listened to your presentations and the issues you raised concerning the National Broadcasting Corporation, the Commission, over its attempt to muzzle you by way of raising issues that has to do with your activities. First and foremost, it is important for us to restate that the National Assembly in the last 4 years has been media friendly, one that has always opened its doors to listen to protests, objections, and even revolt by Nigerians on issues that touches on justice, fundamental rights, and also our democracy. In the light of this, I think it is important for us to understand that the relationship between the media and the National Assembly has been very cordial. Well, in the words of Thomas Jefferson, that our democracy and liberty is dependent on a free press, and that cannot be lost whenever it is limited. And Quincy Adams too make it a very clear point that press freedom is inviolate. Democracy fully depends on having a free press, freely operating to defend and perform the people's oversight function on the affairs of governance. The media in Nigeria will be rightly said to be the pillar of democracy, one that has stood on the side of freedom and justice and led to what we are today enjoying as a democracy. And in the last 2 decades, you have also demonstrated your responsiveness and responsibility in the defense of the ideals of freedom and the unity of this country. Particularly, the AIT has done so much for democracy. Like other media houses, all the issues we have raised on the issue of third term, doctrine of necessity, these are facts we have seen, we have experienced, and whoever is in the position of authority today is a beneficiary of the services of a free media. And having said that, the issues we raised are germane and are also very important as far as the National Assembly is concerned. You come at a time when we are signing off the 8th National Assembly. So it is still not too late, because among us here, there are people who are going to carry the baton to move issues you have raised here to a new phase and ensure that the press is adequately protected and defended. The parliament is the guardian of democracy, and it is within our own constitutional responsibility to protect and defend every Nigerian and any Nigerian where there is a clear attempt to undermine his right to freedom of speech. On behalf of the Senate President, who has mandated us to be here, and also the senators who are here, I believe that your issues will be carried to the last, and we will not allow any institution of government to undermine the liberty that we so much fought, where many people have died and sacrificed their lives to entrench in Nigeria. Without struggle, there could not have been freedom. Without struggle, people have died, people have been jailed to have a democracy in Nigeria. We will not be silenced, or nobody should be silenced, and we will not fold our arms to see people or institutions, components of democracy, being silenced for any reason. I will give the mic to my colleagues,